Hello students, till now we have done the concepts of privatization and liberalization. The last economic reform which came to improve the efficiency and effectiveness of public sector is globalization. Globalization generally means the integration of the domestic economy with the world economy. It is a complex phenomenon. Globalization is the result of the set of various policies that are aimed at transforming the world towards greater independence and integration. It involves creation of networks and activities crossing economic, social, and geographical boundaries. Globalization means turning the world into one whole or creating a borderless world. Actually, globalization is the result of the policies of liberalization and privatization. It aims at free interaction among all the countries of the world in various fields like trade, technology, loan, outsourcing, investment, etc. In the Indian context, it means opening up of the economy to foreign direct investment, joint ventures, and foreign collaborations, and encouraging privatization. As a result of globalization efforts taken by India, we find all types of goods available here. For example, Lee Cooper shoes, Reebok t-shirts, Ray-Ban sunglasses, Coca-Cola and Pepsi, Armani's shirt, Intel's Pentium, etc. have flooded the Indian market. It aims at integrating the world into one global village. By globalization, we mean the expansion of trade all over the world. And this process is successfully undertaken by the multinational corporations known as MNCs. An MNC is one which undertakes foreign direct investments in different countries of the world. It owns or controls income generation assets in more than one country and engages in the process of international production. According to the report of United Nations Center on MNCs, there are so many MNCs in operation with lots of subsidiaries in the world. Before 1990, India had a closed market, which invited foreign technology but not the foreign management. But today, with the entrance of MNCs in India, both of the essential requirements have been available under a single roof. What are the benefits of globalization, or why we should go for globalization? Look the reasons in favor of globalization. Globalization increases the inflow of foreign capital. Secondly, globalization increases the incoming of updated technology. Thirdly, this updated technology reduces the capital output ratio. Reduction of capital output ratio means that with the same amount of capital, we can produce more. Or, for producing same level of output, we need less amount of capital. So, reduction in capital output ratio is the benefit of globalization. Fourthly, globalization developed the export sphere, which in turn increases the degree of competition. Fifth benefit of globalization, that it improves the allocate efficiency of resources. Next benefit, that with the entry of foreign competition and the removal of import tariff barriers, domestic industry will be subject to price reduction and quality improving effect in the domestic economy. It is also believed that due to globalization, efficiency of banking and financial sectors will improve. Globalization has been able to establish links in such a way that the happenings in India can be influenced by events happening in the rest of the world. It provides easy access to global markets. But students, where on one hand side globalization has too much merits, it has some demerits also. For example, experience shows that by globalization, developed economies grew more than developing economies. Because it is generally said that globalization is a policy of the developed countries to expand their markets in other countries. One study has also disclosed that in the process of globalizing the world, the economies are moving away from one another more than coming together. Globalization has widened the economic disparities among nations and people already, which is becoming more rich. So, it is a demerit of globalization. Next demerit is that with the speed at which globalization is taking place, it is increasing the pressure on economies for structural and conceptual readjustment to a breaking point. Breaking point is a point where no profit, no loss situation arises. The globalization creates redistribution of economic power at the world level and redistribution of political power. As we observe, like privatization, there are both merits and demerits of the globalization also. Should we leave globalization because it has demerits? Should we not go for globalization due to its demerits? Of course not. We should see only positive side of globalization because it is heavier than its negative side. The process of globalization is helping our country in becoming more developed. The advantages which we gained from globalization are countless, are numerous, like India's share in world exports has improved. Our foreign exchange reserves have increased many times. Exports now finance over 80% of imports, that is 80% bill of import in India is paid by the earnings of export. It is all due to globalization. Current account deficit has also fallen. Exchange rate for the rupee has remained constant. International confidence in India has been restored. Certain benefits of globalization are in the form of larger variety of consumer goods and their cheaper price. Programs of quality management, research and development have been conducted by corporate sector. More and more companies are opening their branch offices or subsidiaries in other countries and making their presence felt. Asian Paints, Tata's, Sundaram Fasteners, Ranbaxy, Dr. Reddy's Laboratories, Infosys, etc. are examples of Indian companies operating abroad. You don't think this is the benefit of globalization? Now we will throw some light on the measures towards globalization. First among them is opening the Indian economy to foreign capital. The government has taken a number of measures to encourage foreign capital in India. Many facilities and incentives are offered to the foreign investors, non-resident Indians, overseas corporate bodies in the new economic policy. The foreign direct investment have been opened for investment up to 26%, 49%, 51%, 74% and even up to 100% in different industries. Second measure towards globalization is import liberalization. Import duties and tariffs on imports have been cut down. Do you know the peak rate of custom duty was earlier 150% and now it has brought down to just 10%? Means earlier, if you import the commodity, you have to pay the custom duty at the rate of 150% of the value which you have imported. But now it is only 10%. Third measure towards globalization is convertibility of rupee. Convertibility of rupee means allow the economy to determine its own exchange rate in the international market without any official interfere. And luckily, our India achieved full convertibility on current account in August 1994. Current account convertibility means freedom to buy or sell foreign exchange for the current nature transactions, like remittances for family living expenses and payment for interest on loans and investments. Next measure towards globalization is modification in technology agreements. Prior to 1991, there were restrictions for hiring foreign technology or foreign technicians. But according to new economic policy, all foreign collaborations concerning higher technology have been made easy by the government, and now no permission is required for testing domestically developed technology abroad. Next measure towards globalization is that foreign companies have been allowed to use their trademarks in India. Next measure towards globalization is that foreign companies can deal in immovable property also in India. Seventh measure is that restrictions on transfer of shares have been removed. It is supposed that all these measures are towards the integration of Indian economy with the world economy. Now we will discuss the concept of outsourcing. This is one of the important benefits came out of the globalization. It is an emerging business activity. As information technology is growing faster, outsourcing has become an important need of the present times in the international arena. In outsourcing, a company hires regular service from external sources, mostly from other countries, which were previously provided internally or from within the country, like legal advice, computer service, advertisement, security, each provided by the respective department of the company. Outsourcing is a form of economic activity. Today, most of the multinational companies and even small companies are outsourcing their services to India because they can be achieved at a cheaper cost with reasonable degree of skill and accuracy. The main services which are being outsourced to India by the other countries are voice-based business processes known as BPO, record keeping, accountancy, banking services, film editing, book transcription, clinical advice or teaching. With the help of modern telecommunication links, including the internet, the data regarding these services is digitized and transmitted in real time over continents and national boundaries. India has become a destination for global outsourcing in the post-reform period because of low wage rates and availability of skilled manpower. Now, the concept of World Trade Organization. There are many international organizations which have facilitated the process of globalization. Chief among them are IMF, International Monetary Fund, IBRD, International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, and WTO, World Trade Organization. But in our syllabus, we are concerned only about one of such organizations, and that is WTO. World Trade Organization is a powerful body which broadly aims at making the whole world a big village, where there is a free flow of goods, services, capital, technology and people. And not only this, where there are no barriers to trade. WTO is a full-fledged international organization. WTO is a wide concept which cannot be completed in a single lecture. Students, now it is the time which is indicating us to stop here. It all was for today. We will do the remaining WTO with its features and functions in our next and last lecture of this chapter. Let's revise what we have done today. We started with globalization, its merits, demerits. Globalization means integration of Indian economy with the rest of the world. We observed that its merits are more than its demerits. Therefore, we cannot ignore the process of globalization. Then we discussed the positive impact of globalization on Indian economy, then the concept of outsourcing, and a slight introduction of World Trade Organization. In our next and last lecture of this chapter, we will complete the term World Trade Organization and the overall impact of the New Economic Policy 1991 on the Indian economy. Now, thanks for today.